Hi, I'm Evan Kleiman of Good Food, and I'm with you again this morning from a beautiful, windy Southern California day here in Santa Monica. Today, we're going to be learning how to trim an artichoke, both the little baby ones and the big globe ones. And then after we trim, I'm going to be making a beautiful braised artichoke dish, carciofi alla romana, which is the Roman style of braising artichokes in oil with a lot of herbs. When you're picking an artichoke, you want one that's nice and heavy and that feels really tight. The stems are edible. If you can buy baby artichokes instead of a globe, a big artichoke, it's so much easier to clean. They're really beautiful and tender. Hey, Romeo, do you have some herbs for me?
I had an Italian parsley and a Persian mint sago for you.
That's perfect.
Perfect?
Yeah. Okay. So let's pluck. Pluck, 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 pluck. Trim off the leaves. Cut it down. That is just absolutely a thing of beauty. This method is different because you're basically just using your knife to trim the whole artichoke down. When it's done by ladies in the Campo di Fiori market in Rome who have done millions of these in the course of their lifetimes, they do it effortlessly. And their artichokes end up looking like beautiful little flowers. That is perfect. When you're doing this trimming movement, you want to make sure to keep your knife as vertical as possible and not slip to diagonal, because if you slip to diagonal, you're going to end up cutting off a lot of the heart, which is right here. So we're going to start by just peeling off the leaves, and they're so tender that you don't have to do them one at a time. Then we're going to trim the bottom. And as you can see, there's this little circle, which is a continuation of the heart. We're going to cut that away because the part around it tends to be a little more bitter than the center. Prevent the artichoke from darkening by just making a little bit of acidulated water. Trim down the top, cut it in half. So we're done. So here we are, ready to take our beautifully trimmed little baby artichokes and create carciofi alla romana. We have the baby artichokes in a nice quantity of oil. I'm going to take a couple of the lemons that were sitting there in the water and just squeeze them out and squeeze out the water and add them to the artichokes. Minced garlic. So then this is the green garlic, which looks just like a green onion. You're going to chop it down. Add that in. We're going to use this Italian parsley, and as you can see, I'm doing a little chef's trick where I chop these very, very tender stems along with the leaves. It's going to all be braised, so it's okay. It's not like they're going to be in a salad and you're going to get them stuck. These mint leaves are really beautiful. They're very soft and tender. I'm just going to throw them in whole. Some salt. Now, the secret to this dish is how you braise them. How I was taught by my mentor was that you use equal amounts of water and oil. They nearly submerge the artichokes. And this way you don't really have to measure because it's all about volume. Then you're going to turn your fire up. Parchment paper enables you to reduce the cooking time. You take the paper and you put it directly onto the ingredients so there's no gap between them. Effectively, what I've done is I've moved the lid from the top of the pan down to all the way on top of the vegetables. As much as I love cooking outdoors, and I love it a lot, sometimes Mother Nature just doesn't cooperate. So the offshore breezes of Santa Monica blew us all the way here into Melrose to my place, Angeli Cafe. I threw the artichokes on the stove so you could see what they're like when they're done. Carciofi alla romana, artichokes braised with herbs and oil. So let's taste. Oh, that's really good. It's delicious. And you can do this way ahead and serve it at room temperature. One of the beauties of antipasti. We will have the recipe for you on the website at kcrw.com/goodfood. Take care until next time.